pictures. They have Santa there, and they often have snow that they do there, and a lot of fun. We have one of the artists on from that Sawdust Festival, Elizabeth Bernbeck. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
And you were telling me before we got on that this is your very first festival that you're going to be a part of.
I'm super excited. I've been a visitor for several years throughout my life, and this is the first year I'm there as an artist, and it's a really magical thing to be a part of, and I'm super proud to be a part.
Yeah, everyone I've ever heard just really that has been there and come on our show, they absolutely love it. And the winter one is a very shortened season compared to summer, but it's a lot of fun and it's different, and you know, just that holiday spirit is, you know, you look at the pictures here, they got the Christmas trees up, and they do the snowflakes that come down, and they have Santa and music and caroling and all that kind of stuff. So
they do. It runs for 4 weekends, and yes, they'll have Santa and carolers, and I believe there'll even be a petting zoo. And over 170 artists will exhibit, and everybody handcrafts all their items. Everything's really unique, and it's a wonderful place to shop and get inspired.
Yeah. And like you said, you used to go there. Now you are a participant. Tell me about the kinds of things that you do. I looked online. It said you did jewelry, lampshades, scarves. Obviously, you do other things as well.
Yes. Well, first I'll say that the lampshades, they are all upcycled materials, and I find items like old crystals from antique chandeliers and things like that, and I've even used like chicken coop wire and things like that, and so they're really unique and one of a kind.
Do you start with, when you do the lampshades, a base lampshade you buy, like a simple white lampshade, or?
You know, sometimes I'll create the wire base myself, and sometimes I'll find old discarded lampshades at a thrift shop or something, and I'll strip it all down just to the basics of the metal.
Oh, okay, so you have that frame.
Yeah, and then I just start everything from scratch from that point.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
All right, so tell me about, you got some scarves here.
I do.
It looks like you got some little, like, doll little owls,
okay,
I guess.
Okay, these are my free-to-be-me owls.
Let me and hold these up.
I love them. Each one is unique, one of a kind, different shapes, different sizes. And I particularly enjoy these because I think a lot of times in life we are always looking for how we're similar or how to be like another person. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I think our beauty lies in just in our uniqueness and the ways that we're all different. So these kind of celebrate that, and they're just really whimsical. And I line them all up, and they're beautiful. They make you feel good.
Yeah, they do. They're very nice, and obviously you do a bunch of different ones and just
yes.
have them all ready to go. And
yeah.
Very nice. Yeah. I like those. And you sew these, obviously,
yes.
because I know you have to do your own work.
Yes.
And are these...
these are crocheted.
Crocheted. I don't know the difference between crochet and knitting.
These are crocheted. And
they're really soft.
Aren't they? It's a beautiful yarn I found for this year. I call these my angel scarves because they're so incredibly soft, and it's just really nice to wrap, you know, yourself up in them, and you feel loved.
Yeah, they.
It's one of the softest yarns
they
I've
are
ever
really,
found.
Yeah, they're really. Yeah, is it a certain type?
It's a type of acrylic mix.
Oh, it's acrylic.
Yeah.
Really? Wow.
Then we have also wool yarns and different things like that, and cotton blends.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah.
I would have thought it was something a little bit different, like a natural, but the fact that it's acrylic, I never would have guessed that.
Yeah.
So I know you do a whole different ones of this. You're going to show us a certain one that you have
I
there.
I will. We make
adult
sizes, and then we make smaller sizes for kids. These are candy ones,
mm-hmm.
and we have a variety of colors. Also, these come in a variety of colors. We have purple, blue, red, browns, many lovely colors. And they all have different little flower clips with them, too. We make the flower clips.
Okay.
They're separate. So you can
put
those in your
okay,
hair or, you know, on your shirt or embellish them in any way. And then, you know, sometimes it's nice to wrap yourself up in a scarf, you know, like that. But then sometimes...
Okay, you're going to show us
I'm
this.
I'm going to demonstrate this one here.
Okay.
Sometimes, you know, you don't want the tails of the scarf necessarily, you know, tucked in your jacket or whatever. And it's nice to still stay snugly and warm.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Like that, so it stays in place.
Oh, it's very
like
nice.
That. Yeah.
How did you get into all this? Is it something you've done for years, or it's just more recent?
Well, you know, I love possibility and potential. So I like finding raw materials and The yarns I particularly love because they're so soft and cozy. But I like taking items and just finding new ways to create things that hopefully will make people happy.
What was the process of getting into the sawdust? Because I know during the summer is almost next to impossible. They have a lottery program. You have to be a Laguna resident.
Correct.
Laguna Beach resident.
Right.
But you live in San Clemente, so the Winter Festival is a little bit more open.
It's a little more open. So it's open to people who live in the area, not just Laguna Beach exclusively. Mm-hmm. And there's a panel of about 8 to 10 artists who you present your work to. And so they judge your work. And I'm very lucky to be a part of it this year.
Yeah, it sounds like a lot of fun. And you also do, it said on the online anyway, you do jewelry. Do you do that as well?
Yes, I won't have jewelry at this festival. I wanted to focus more on the warm items for winter.
Okay.
But yeah, I do.
Have you done other festivals other than the Sawdust Festival? I mean, obviously, you've been doing these for a while. So
right.
Are there the craft fairs and things like that?
That's true. And I've sold a lot of things at barn sales, particularly mm-hmm. down in the San Diego County area.
At barn sales?
Yeah, barn sales.
Wait, literally a barn being sold? Or you're talking about they call that and then different craftspeople come
yes.
in inside a barn
yeah,
or something like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, yeah. It can be like inside a barn or like an outdoor flea market type
okay.
setting. Yeah.
All right. When you are at the festival, I know during the summer, because it's much longer, the
right.
artists, and it's every day, the artists can set up and they're doing work there throughout the day. Do you do that here?
Yes, and actually I will be teaching a class. Also, they have classes there, and I'll mm-hmm. be teaching a class on how to do the flowers. But even though it's a shortened amount of time, we still set up our own booths and decorate and my booth this year, I set up a theme that's kind of like a Dr. Seuss cartoon type booth for the kids mm-hmm. in particular. And it's exciting. We have a telephone setup where on one side of the wall you can speak in and
oh,
it goes
that's kind of neat.
Yeah, through piping to the other side.
Yeah, well,
yeah.
That's a lot of fun. And you said about 170 artists there,
yes.
So it's a good amount. And there's a lot of activities down there. Now, the difference is it does not go every day. It goes from weekends, November 23rd to December 15th, and obviously that would include the Friday after Thanksgiving, correct?
It does. It's Saturdays and Sundays, but the second weekend will include Friday. Black
okay.
Friday, we're open.
Yeah, that's what I thought. A lot of fun down there, and you can go online if you want to find out more about it. Just go ahead and go to sawdustfestival.org, and then under festivals, pick the winter one. You can get all the information. The ticket information is all there. And also are the artists' information is there as well. So if you want to find out more about Elizabeth or any one of the other artists there, they're all listed there, and you can get all the information you need. A lot of fun.
Thank
and
you.
The kids, I think they like this one probably better than the summer just because of the old holiday theme. And it's a lot of fun down
it's
there.
It's very much oriented towards children and
yeah.
families.
Thank you for coming on. It was nice to have you. Good luck down there.
Thank
maybe
you.
We'll see you in the summer. Of course, you'd have to move. Then, right?
I would need to move,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, you would. All right. Well, maybe you'll be a winter festival regular then.
Okay.
All right. We'll be back in just a moment.